Greetings, fellow Lookings. Welcome back to Rules of Fools. Today's mission at hand is Operation Storm Chaser. Judging by the nature of the operation, it seems to be the penultimate mission in this campaign, and for this entire game as well, because, well, we're attacking this campaign at the very end of the game. But, yeah, the objective is simple. Destroy the crates containing the enemy's nuclear launch codes. And after this, maybe we will be going after the nukes themselves, and hopefully that is also where the general would be. So let us go in and check this out. Not a bad map, but I feel like I've seen this terrain before. Even though the objective markers are a little different this time around, the terrain feels very similar to, you know, the kind of maps we have seen before, and it seems that the objective is inside of a valley, which should make it easy, but I doubt it would. Let's see. Let's go and see anyway. Execution. Proceed from your ingress point 100 meters northeast of Objective Giant. I wonder why the objective is called Giant. The crates are being stored at multiple locations within the complex. Once the crates are destroyed, proceed northwest approximately 195 meters to Objective Samson. Eliminate any enemy resistance there and secure a landing zone for your extraction. I see. So, again, yet again, we need to clear the lander. So, all of the crates at Objective Giant and all resistance at Objective Samson must be eliminated in order for this mission to be successful. Expected enemy forces. Excuse me. Weather conditions have eased, allowing enemy patrols to increase. Oh no. I was sort of getting happy that there aren't as many enemies on this map. Visible at least, but apparently I was getting happy for no reason. At least they're not making us go through, you know, huge ingress routes like they were in the earlier campaigns, in this campaign at least. It's more of a insert, get straight into the action kind of a campaign, from what I can tell. Air photographic reconnaissance shows that both objective areas are heavily patrolled. Photo analysis indicates that you can expect to encounter up to 4 squads of infantry supported by artillery and light armor. Yikes. Light armor as well, huh? And artillery. Are we... I don't think we've ever have faced the risk of, you know, mortars being dropped on us, but I suppose that is a very real problem that we can face in this game. I mean, if only the enemy had mortars, but pretty sure that the laser designator can actually be used against enemies in multiplayer mode. But then again, I'm not sure, because I've never played multiplayer on this game. Allied support. Alpha team will insert approximately 320 meters to the west of Objective Giant. They will advance due west, engaging enemy patrols in the area. Once you have neutralized Objective Giant, they will join you at Objective Samson. Charlie team will insert approximately 190 meters south of Objective Giant. Their axis of advance will initially be northeast, then they will swing to the northwest. They will time their advance so as to attack the southeast perimeter of Objective Giant as you attack the northeast perimeter. I see. Let's hope we can catch each other in the crossfire. But okay. Once Objective Giant is neutralized, they will join you at Objective Samson. Again, standard eliminate everybody mission. Today, US Naval Forces intercepted one of 3 merchant crafts carrying electronic components necessary for the launching of nuclear warheads. NSC satellites were able to lock onto the remaining ships and were able to follow the transportation of the equipment to its final destination. It is imperative that these components be destroyed before they can be used. The coordinates of the site where the crates were delivered is designated Objective Giant. I see. So let's just go ahead and confirm whether the gears are alright or not. And yeah, I would like to make 2 changes. First off, I would rather like to carry the law. I don't know why they are recommending the law, because we don't have to destroy anything here. So why the law and the cycle charges? Seems useless, so I'll just go for the double load ammo. As for the sidearm, I'll keep it to the Spec Ops 45. Let me just confirm whether we have to, like, destroy something. Yeah, we do actually. My bad. You know, honestly, I can't read sometimes, and that's completely on me. So hopefully that would be enough ammunition for us to use. And let's go ahead and start this mission then. Okay,
Bravo team, move into the camp. Alpha and Charlie, secure the perimeter.
Roger, King 6. I mean, the starting of this mission at least is pretty straightforward. It just gets a little worse over time. That's the problem. And could you, like, get back up, sir? So that I can shoot you? Thank you. One enemy down. What about the second one? Can you go down, sir? Thank you so much. There's only like one person per bunker in here. So it's sort of a good thing. But I didn't expect to make that shot at all. I think it actually missed, but yeah. But that guy's dead, so who am I to argue? It's sort of strange how this how the hit detection in this game works sometimes. Sometimes, like, shots that actually have the trajectory to hit the opponent don't. And shots that should be missing, you know, hit them square. So, it's a little difficult to tell which shot is going to hit and which is going to miss before it actually hits them. Charlie 1 and 2. Please be cautious, Charlie 1 and 2.
I have eye on the chopper. Charlie 1 is down!
Kindly proceed to destroy the chopper.
Target confirmed. Destroy all vehicles.
This is Alpha! Charlie is down! Charlie is down!
So soon this time around? The previous time around, Charlie was actually playing pretty well. And they took their time dying. They didn't die so easily or quickly. There were some people coming over from here as well. And apparently this time they aren't. This is a nice little cranny for me to hide in. A nice little nook. From here, I think I should be able to see this guy as well. And it would appear that Charlie has already taken care of them. There you guys are. And you guys are no more. There should be a few people running across this hill here. Just right for the taking. Excuse me. I'm trying to edit out all the cuffs and pauses from this game, but if any of them do manage to make it in, my apologies in advance. This guy's running, and quite effectively at that. Finally got shot in the nards. Oh, that was a bird. I was wondering how is somebody hauling ass at such high speeds. No enemies over here. Should be a few more coming over the hill here. This guy, for example. These guys won't even, you know, like, give a fuck whether they're getting shot or not. They just keep running, which is quite strange to me, actually. But yeah, there are a few of them here, and it's mostly the AI glitching out. Where's this guy? Come over, I'm gonna shoot you quick. Come over. I just wanna shoot you, come over. Show yourself. Wait, what? Really? Really like the fact that there's an extra round in the chamber, right, like that. I think the coast should be clear now. We can feel free to move on. Unless there are a few more enemies here that we should take out first. That can cause a problem for us later. It does not really seem to be the case for now. Let's keep moving. And as and when we keep seeing enemies, our job is simply to take them out. That is a tree. Enemy over here. Eliminated. There's also a chopper there that I need to eliminate as well. I'm debating whether or not to actually use the law on the chopper. That enemy is down. Now, typically, that is a good spot to actually target the chopper from, but that area sort of opens you up to a lot of enemies. So it what is advised is some caution when approaching that area. Another enemy down. I do not think there are any more enemies on top of this rooftop here. Excuse me, who shot me? I cannot see any of the enemies who shot at me and got away with it on top of that. Somebody did though. Yeah, where is this guy? I can't see him, like at all. I can't see him at all. And yeah, that sort of displeases me that I cannot see that guy. That is one threat out of the way. Hopefully I would be alive long enough to, you know, reap the benefits of having destroyed the chopper ahead of time. Now, I am hearing some fire headed in my direction. You still aren't dead? Huh. That's lucky for you, I suppose. Are there any more enemies there? I would suppose so. I suppose you were the one who was shooting at me. Oh wait, there's another enemy on top of the roof there. I suppose that was the guy who was shooting at me, wasn't he? Wasn't it? There's another enemy down there. I think that's another enemy. Yes, it is. I've already been tagged once, which, you know, takes away the only life I have. You only have two chances in this game. Two lives. Now, I just gotta be a little careful in my ingress to this area, because there are enemies all across the mountaintop here, and if you aren't careful of them, they can like pretty easily shoot you down. So yeah, be careful when advancing is my advice, general advice to people here. The chopper is downed, which takes like a huge edge away from the enemy. I cannot see any more enemies thus far. Wait, I suppose I could. This one right there. Maybe another right somewhere in there? No? No. You need to also need to be mindful of the angles in this game, because a lot of times the enemies can use unconventional angles to get the drop on you. And yeah. I suppose that was not an enemy then. I think I see somebody standing in front, but of course I cannot reach them because they're protected by a grill of sorts. I think I hear some fire from over there.
Alpha 1 is down!
Oh no. Alpha, be careful. You're the only person I can rely on. Alpha, come on Alpha, be careful. I'll just get down on all fours so that I can approach this area a little better without exposing myself too much. And that's, I feel like that's all that I've been doing throughout this entire campaign. Getting down on all fours so that I am less noticed. I really hope that was not Alpha 2. That was Alpha 2. Oh no. Are those people not dead yet? Nope, no they are not. The person inside the bunker. I wonder how... Does this guy have like a ton of hit points, or is it just that I'm just that bad a shot? Because I could have sworn this guy should have been dead by now. Instead, I'm here trying to kill this guy while he's not dying. He's just not interested in dying at all. I did not see any enemies down there. A scan of the area underneath. The mountain seems to be clear. Scanning this area for hostiles. That guy was not dead, now he is. There's like a certain look to dead enemies in this game. Like you can easily notice them. You see how there's like an entirely distinct dark patch over there? Yeah, that's how dead enemies normally look in this game. So if your dead enemies don't look like that, you can be 100% certain they are not dead at this point in time. Hopefully, if that was an actual guy, he died. Otherwise, I wasted all my shots without achieving any sort of proper results. Now, I can see a lot of people down there on the map. You cannot see them in real life. That sort of is a cause for concern for me. That is another alive enemy. Oh no, that is actually a dead enemy. That is a tree. Especially on this, that guy was still alive. What was he doing? I mean, why was he not shooting at me? I'm guessing that guy's dead. Okay. Got it. So what I'm just gonna do here is I'm gonna get up here and I'm just gonna keep moving around this area, eliminating any threats that I see here so that I can... That honestly looks like a person. That honestly does. The bunker seems clear. I'm just being extra cautious here. You don't have to be this cautious, but it definitely helps, is all I'm saying. See, I mean, I missed something over there. Well, that is Alpha 1. Even dead Alpha 1 looks more prominent than an alive enemy. I sometimes wonder whether that is so because I am upscaling this game to a resolution it wasn't designed for. Yes, that's what I thought it was. Yeah, and that is like the exfiltration base. I suppose I might as well take them out now itself since they are in the way of my path to clear the objective. Since they are posing problems, might as well eliminate them. I do not think I see any more enemies. Not pointed right at me at least. Of course, I do not have to approach the objective from this side around as well. I can like go around the other way. I'm betting there are quite a few more enemies inside of this housing complex right here. But we'll get to them when we get to them. For now, I just want to storm the... Storm this thing. There is another guy right over there, in front of that thing over there. No people out of this building. Another enemy spotted. That is another enemy, and I don't know what he was doing not shooting at me. Just a lamppost. Is that an enemy? No, that is a dead enemy. Enemy turned dead enemy. I cannot sight anymore, I cannot spot anymore. Which is good news, which always is good news. I think I saw somebody there. A guy lying prone on the ground, another enemy. Didn't even do a scope in that one. I guess that is just dead enemy, because he did not react to getting shot. When in doubt, shoot. Is what I would like to say. Now, it shows me that there are some enemies over here. Probably another enemy somewhere over here as well. It says, I have not been able to see such an enemy, but they're definitely somewhere over here. Probably inside this cranny here or somewhere. I just need to approach this thing cautiously. No, Now, the problem with getting a new angle for surveillance is that you also expose yourself to enemies invisible to you from that angle. So, yeah, you just need to do it very cautiously, as cautiously as possible. That is Alpha 1. There's a dead enemy here. There should be another enemy somewhere over here. I just can't see them. Maybe hidden in this nuke, perhaps. Somewhere over here. Behind the hill, perhaps. Reloading. I know I said that a little late, but yeah. Are these the objectives that we need to destroy, I wonder? I doubt it though. I do not think these are the objectives that we need to destroy. I'm just gonna move over to this end and make a swift maneuver so as to not expose myself to unnecessary displeasantries. There's like an enemy right on top there. Eliminate enemies as and when I see them here. There is somebody right on top of that hill, and I would just be a little more comfortable knowing that they have been taken care of. Instead of having to, you know, instead of me finding out that they are actually an active combatant after I am shot through the back by them. There you go. Good thing that these guys can't shoot for shit. Otherwise it would be really difficult in this mission. I mean, I think they sort of scaled out the level of skill that the AI has as we keep advancing further and further through in the game. Because typically these enemies would be able to shoot you at first sight and kill you while doing so. But it's just a tree. I need to approach this guy cautiously because otherwise he will definitely be killing me. So I'll just try flanking him. Going around here. It says there's definitely an alive enemy here. Probably up there. I don't want any problems in my hand. Here's the primary reason I'm doing things this way. Let me just go ahead and walk as well. Typically, the enemies aren't really sensitive to this kind of thing. The enemy AI in this game, I mean. But you never know. You never know how they can react. And this guy might just be, you know, like super talented and might, like, 180 degree no scope. Where is this guy? Oh, right here. Hiding away. In a no good corner of the world. Of this map, rather. That guy's dead, it would seem. And in doing so, I seem to have exposed myself quite a bit. Luckily, nobody shot me from behind. Cannot see any more enemies here. I suppose this side is clear, and so is the landing base, almost, except for that. Well, that building, that hut sort of thing. Not exactly hut. What should I call it? Checkpoint power object chant right here. Not that I exactly need the waypoint markers for this map, because I mean, I can see what quite easily without it. I thought that was an enemy, apparently it is not. Now, I would be really pissed off if it turns out to actually be an enemy. I'm getting shot from somewhere. I just can't figure out who it is. That's a dead enemy. Excuse me. Is that guy inside the bunker? Nope. He's not. I wonder where this guy is. Who's... Oh, there you are. Yeah. Now you're dead, aren't you? Apparently I hit somebody with that shot as well, and I honestly cannot figure out who it is that I hit. A few more enemies there, I think. Like two enemies inside that shed, or rather that hangar, one enemy inside the shed, and one enemy inside the multi-story building here. So, like a few enemies inside that multi-story building. Two inside here, one inside there, and like multiple inside there. Enemy sighted. Another enemy sighted. That should take care of those two. I just wanna be cautious not to stay too close to these things. And the buildings, I mean, one enemy was outside, taken care of. There's definitely one enemy inside of this building here. I just need to be a little cautious as to any enemies standing near the windows, because they are the ones that can usually be leaving. And I typically dislike these maps because of all the buildings, this game has a bug where if you get too close to buildings, the game crashes. Like it can randomly crash, it has like a chance of crashing. And yeah, I just terribly dislike that feature of this game. Good news is, I can just chuck grenades in there without ever getting close. Oh, that works. Now all the enemies that remain are inside of that last building over there. And well, let me just go ahead and destroy the crates inside here first. I think all I need to do is just shoot the crates. So that should not be too difficult. I think these are the crates. That is the crate that I need to shoot. So let me just pull out the law and Geronimo, and the damn thing has been reloaded as well. So that's good news. I'm just gonna go up here and try to find any enemies that might be at me from out there. There you are. I thought there was somebody in there. I'm usually never wrong about these things. Now I'm actually trying to keep my distance as much as possible from this building because of the same bug that I was talking about before. It's very easy to pretty much just, you know, get caught up in the bug and just die, or rather have to restart the game all over again. So I don't want that to happen. I think one of them is downstairs. Oh, there you are. Let me just go ahead. And now that I cannot see any more enemies there, let me just take a stock of how many are left. Seemingly only one. There's just one more enemy behind me, but I will not bring them too much mind. Let me just go ahead and be a little more cautious in my approach. I think the enemy should be upstairs. And yeah, let's see. Let's hope we can take the objective out using grenades. We don't need to rely on well, anything else out there. And I just don't want to risk going and having to go inside this building here. Because typically that's a bad move. It makes the game bug out, freeze. Okay, a little lower perhaps.
Target destruction confirmed. Move to the extraction point.
Roger, King 6. I'm just gonna let that guy
This in. Is Black Widow. ETA is 3 mics.
Roger, Black Widow. Moving to the extraction point. Hopefully I won't be getting shot from this angle. Oh, come on, move. So that was relatively simple. Let's hope that clearing the extraction point is just as simple and not too much of a hassle. A pain in the ass, as they like to put it. Pardon my French, that is our Black Widow! Yay! Now let me just circle this extraction point once and confirm that there are no enemies, no hostiles threatening us from the outside. There seem to be none on this end anyway. Let me just go ahead and run over to the other end to make sure that there aren't any enemies over there on that side. Now, since the Black Widow is here, why can't it just go ahead and clear the area out itself, is what I want to say from time to time. But anyway, let me just pause again for a second. I think it is doing just that. I mean, I said it should clear out the area and it is doing exactly that. My god, look at you. Black Widow. Way to go, Black Widow. What's a kill count right now? Come on, you can share those reels with me. Give it the deets, Black Widow. I swear I won't tell on you. That guy's down, and I think one final guy should be remaining somewhere over here. No? Probably outside, then. If he's not in here, then he's definitely outside. Then just get the better angle on him by going up there, upstairs, like on top of the mountain. And, he's probably inside of this bunker right here. And probably the guy that Black Widow is trying to target. I do not want to get too close to these buildings until absolutely necessary. Nobody in there. Definitely somebody inside these bunkers. The bunker, rather. It's just one bunker complex. Not even a complex, it's just an entire bunker. That guy's down. And that's the end of that. We didn't need to make it up there. So, cool. Let's check out the debriefing then. Mining a pretty straightforward mission, not too difficult. I'm surprised at how easy these missions have become. Or maybe it's just that I'm getting a little more used to playing cautiously instead of just going intense basic like I used to before. So, yeah, because I mean, the fact that I'm not getting a lot of incoming fire as well sort of goes to, you know, prove that, and I am sniping, going ahead, taking the enemy from an angle that they wouldn't be, you know, encouraged to fire back, or from a position where they are severely disadvantaged, using everything I have to my advantage. I think I have become a better player over time at, you know, warfare. Not a fair player, but definitely a better player, I would say. 57 kills. Just a minute. Your destruction of their nuclear weapons launch electronics prevents the enemy from using the weapons effectively, but they are still a threat. All enemy ground forces have surrendered, with the exception of those forces in control of the nuclear weapons storage facility. Bravo team is ordered to immediately attack this facility and secure the nuclear weapons. Enemy leaders have threatened to launch these weapons and blind. Enemy leaders have threatened to launch these weapons blind and let the destruction fall wherever it may. Now here's the thing. Here's why targeting equipment is so necessary, and it's the fact that in the majority of the surface of the Earth, it's covered with water, and a lot of it is not actually habited, inhabited by humans. So yeah, if you launch them blind, there are very high chances that the nuke actually falls and explodes inside an ocean, above an ocean, or maybe somewhere in a forest area, somewhere in the desert, or some place where there is no habitation at all, and it'll just radiation poison the area for no, you know, it'll just fill the area out of nuclear fallout for no good reason whatsoever. I mean, not that killing people is a good reason, but yeah, it serves no purpose is what I'm trying to say. Enemy leaders are threatened to get blind and the destruction fall away with me. Our weapon experts don't believe that they can pull this off, but the risk is too great to be left to chance. Exactly. So there is, of course, a chance that it will land somewhere important or somewhere with people. So I suppose we do need to capture the nukes from rebels, at least. And that unlocks Operation Snow Fox, which is, I'm guessing, the final mission of this campaign. Capture the supply base to the needed objective Nova, where the enemy is storing the nuclear weapons. And that's pretty much like the end of this campaign and this game. And looking back at it, well, I'll just save that for the next video. For today, thank you for tuning in. The next time we come back to Delta Force in our final video of Delta Force, we will be covering Operation Snow Fox. And I will say final video because I'm not exactly looking forward to replaying this game. Like, I promise I would say that at the end of, the Operation Snow Fox. But yeah, I'm not looking forward to playing this game, but I am open to playing this in a cooperative mode with maybe a team of other players. So let's see, maybe if somebody's up for it, we could work something out. But until then, this is it for Operation Snow Fox will be the final video of Delta Force, and we'll get to it when we get to it. So the next time we see each other, we'll be capturing Operation Snow Fox along with the enemy nuclear supply base, objective Nova. Until then, take care. Thank you for watching. Farewell, fellow things.